Hello aspirants, welcome to KK MathTuber, learn with Kiran sir. In this today video session, we will talk on the topic Linear Inequalities, KCET. So before we go into the problems regarding linear inequalities, so we will look at few concepts regarding linear inequalities, few important remarks regarding linear inequalities. If you learn those important remarks, properties of linear inequalities, within 5 seconds, you can able to answer questions from these linear inequalities. If we look at the analysis, the kind of questions which has been asked from 2014 to 2020, a similar kind of question has been asked. If you look at those properties, you can able to apply in that and get the solutions in 5 seconds. Therefore, watch this video till the end. One question sure will be asked in the KCET for this coming examinations, and you can secure 1 marks from this chapter very, very easily. So let's begin. First, let us know what are inequalities, what are linear inequalities, and during the process of solving inequalities, what are the rules to be followed. So what are inequalities? You considered any two number or an algebraic expressions if they are related by symbols. So what are the symbols? This, you know, it is greater than or equal to, less than or equal to. So these are said to form an inequalities. And what are linear inequalities? An expression of the form ax plus b greater than c, or an expression of the form ax plus b greater than or equal to c, or an expression of the form ax plus b less than c, or you can write ax plus b less than or equal to c. So these are called linear inequalities with the condition that a should be non-zeros. If a becomes zero, it just becomes a numbers. So a should be non-zeros, and all these a, b and c are real numbers. So these are called linear inequalities. Now the question is how to solve these linear inequalities. During the process of solving the linear inequalities, certain rules you need to follow it. So let us identify. Let us say that a and b are the two real numbers. Let a and b are two real numbers. Okay. So now let us consider a is greater than b. If I write a greater than b, this implies a plus k is greater than b plus k. I can write this where k is any real number. So k is any real number. So what is the meaning of it? So this means you can add any number on both the sides, inequality will remain the same. The first rule. So the second rule is, so let me write the first rule. Second rule, if a greater than b, this implies k into number a, that is strictly greater than k into b. So where k is strictly greater than 0. So that means for positive real numbers, a very important point, for k greater than 0, so k into a is always greater than k into b, inequality will not reverse in this case also. So when does the inequality will reverse? When k is less than 0. So let us take that as a third point. So that means if a greater than b implies k into a will be less than k into b, so where k is less than 0. So that means whenever you are multiplying a negative real numbers on both the sides, inequality will reverse. Or let us say that if you divide negative numbers on both the sides, inequality will reverse. So this is very, very standard properties, standard rule which you should apply during the solving linear inequalities. And one more property or a rule, if a is greater than b, this implies I can write 1 by a, if you take reciprocal on both the sides, so 1 by a will be less than 1 by b. So these are the basic rules which you need to follow in order to solve any linear inequalities. So next, we will consider the absolute value of a real number. So that we call it as a mod functions. For mod functions, how to solve it? So that is very, very important for KCET point of it. You need to understand how to solve the modulus functions, how to find out the values of x, where does the solution set exist for a mod function. So that we will see it. Okay, now let us see the results related to the absolute value of a real number. How to get the solution set for a absolute values of a real number. First important remarks. So we are not going to prove it, but these remarks are very important which you need to know it. When mod x is less than a, when mod x is less than a, where a is some real number. So this implies, where does x belongs to? X belongs to minus a to plus a. That is in case of intervals. How can you write? X belongs to open interval minus a to plus a, because it is strictly less than, therefore it should be open interval minus a to plus a. So whenever mod function is less than a, so x lies between minus a to plus a. We can able to prove it easily, but now it is important for you to remember this. The same thing, so when you understand this first case, so similarly you can able to understand for the second case. If mod x is less than or equal to a, so what does it implies? It just implies that x lies between minus a to plus a, but including minus a as well as plus a. That is, in case of interval, how will you write? X belongs to minus a to plus a. So hope you understand this. Okay, now third property, very important. If mod x is strictly greater than a, so what does it implies? Where does value of x lies? X will be greater than a, or x is less than minus a. In case of interval, how will you write? So look at this, x is less than minus a ka matlab, minus infinity se minus a tak. So x belongs to minus infinity to minus a, union we write as a union, including x greater than a matlab, a to infinity. So this is the interval where x belongs to minus infinity to minus a, open union a to infinity. So whenever mod x is greater than a, so once you understand mod x greater than a, you can easily understand mod x greater than or equal to a. So what does it implies? X greater than or equal to a, or x less than or equal to minus a. That's all the inequality, you just need to add it. So that is, in terms of interval, how will you write? X belongs to minus infinity to minus a, it should be close, union close a to infinity. So these are the four standard inequalities with respect to the absolute value of real numbers. So once you understand this, just two more properties I will explain it. So these properties are very very important to note down, and for sure question will be asked from these properties only. Hope you understand. Okay, now look at the fifth property, very very important standard form of questions will be asked. If mod of x minus r is less than or equal to a, where does your x lies? See that you can easily answer it. First, we know that mod x less than or equal to a, so we know minus a less than or equal to x minus r less than or equal to plus a, right? Now I need to know where does x belongs to. So what we need to do? Add plus r on both the sides. That's what we have learned the rule. So that means it is r minus a less than or equal to x less than or equal to r plus a. So very very standard remark which you can note down, and easily one can solve this question. Just if you remember this, then this problems can be solved very easily. So in terms of interval, how will you write? In terms of interval, so that is x belongs to, look at here, it is r minus a to r plus a. If this question is asked, within 2 seconds you can answer this question very easily. So this is with respect to less than or equal to a. Next, sixth property, if mod of x minus r is greater than or equal to a, so we are writing for less than or equal to a and greater than or equal to a. So this implies for less than a also, greater than a also, wahan pe kya hoga? Close interval nahi hoga. So that point you should make a note. So in this case, so what happens? X minus r will be greater than or equal to a, or you can write x minus r is less than or equal to minus a. Okay, now shift this r to that side, that means adding r on both the sides. X greater than or equal to a plus r, or x less than or equal to minus a plus r, just adding r on both the sides. That is, in terms of intervals, you write down, so that is x belongs to, look at this term, less than or equal to minus a plus r, that means minus infinity is minus a plus r. Okay, but here we should make it as close union x greater than or equal to a plus r, so close interval a plus r to infinity. So note on these important properties, fifth and sixth properties are important, because when we solve previous year questions of 2020, 2019, 2018, 17, this kind of question has been asked. So if you know this result, so within 2 to 3 seconds you can answer it very very easily. Okay, so note down. Okay, let's begin with the previous year questions. So first question, KCET 2019. So what kind of question it is? If mod of 3x minus 5 less than or equal to 2, then where does x belongs to? So quite easily, just now we have done a remark. If you have not noted down, first go through that and come back to this. So easily one can solve it, because look at here, mod of 3x minus 5 less than or equal to 2a. So it is just like mod x less than or equal to a. So we know that it lies between minus a to plus a. So what you can do is minus 2 less than or equal to 3x minus 5 less than or equal to 2. I need to know where does x belongs to. What you need to do? So first minus 5, add plus 5 on both the sides. So what will you get? Minus 2 plus 5 is 3 less than or equal to 3x less than or equal to 5 plus 2 is 7. Now what you have to do is divide 3 on both the sides. So dividing positive number on both the sides, inequality will remain same as it is. So this implies, so 3 divided by 3 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 7 divided by 3, and you got an answer for this. So this implies 1 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 7 by 3, and now you should tell me which is the right option if you look at this. So 1 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 7 by 3, therefore option C is the right answer. So how much seconds it will take? Once you know if this single property, it is enough, I can able to get the solution of it. It's not necessary to remember also. If you just know this, the next step you can able to do it very easily. So I think you got it. Note down. So next we will go for KCET 2018 question. Okay, the next question. So this question has been asked in KCET 2018. So look at the question. If mod of x plus 5 greater than or equal to 10, then, so these are the four options. By looking at the options only, we can able to guess what is the answer. First, anyway, let us solve it. And looking at the options, how to get the solutions. So that also we look at. So in this case, you look at the inequality is greater symbol. Mod of x plus 5 greater than or equal to 10. So we have learnt mod x greater than or equal to a. So what does it implies? Either x plus 5 is greater than or equal to 10, or you can write x plus 5 is less than or equal to minus 10. So which we have explained it. So now I need to know where does x belongs to. Subtract minus 5 on both the sides. So x greater than or equal to 10 minus 5 is 5. Or here what is? If you subtract 5 on both the sides, what will you get? Minus 10 minus 5 will be minus 15. Now it is in terms of intervals, therefore that is x belongs to, you look at this, x less than or equal to minus 15, that means minus infinity is a minus 15, it should be closed, less than or equal to a union symbol, greater than or equal to 5 means 5 to infinity. So hope you understand. So therefore, which is the right option? So look at minus infinity to minus 15, close union 5 to infinity. Therefore, option C is the right answer. So in this case, by looking at option only, we can able to guess. First one is greater than or equal to 10. So therefore, it cannot be only one interval. So two options, you can delete it easily. And if you look at the option D, minus infinity is closed. It's not at all possible. Minus infinity plus infinity cannot be a closed interval. By just looking at the options, we can say that option C is the right answer. And we have explained it out. So hope you understand. And even this can be solved within 5 seconds. Okay, next question. So this question has been asked in KCET 2017. So look at what is the question. If mod of x minus 2 is less than or equal to 1, then. So these are the options. Again, I will tell you by just looking at the options, I can say which is the right one. Anyway, first let us explain it. So look at here, mod of x minus 2 less than or equal to 1. Quickly, we know that how to write this. So minus 1 to plus 1. Okay. Mod of x minus 2 lies between minus 1 to plus 1. I need to know where does x belongs to. So what do you have to do? Add 2 on both the sides. Inequality will not change. Minus 1 plus 2 is 1. Less than or equal to x. Less than or equal to 1 plus 2 is 3. So we got the answer. What is the solution? 1 to 3 including 1 and including 3. That is in terms of interval it is. Close interval 1 to 3. So now tell me which is the right option. Option A is the right answer. Because look at option B. Close nahi hai. Option C is also 1 close and 1 is open. Option D also, look at both are the close. And here the symbol is less than or equal to 1. So therefore, just by looking at option also, we can able to say it. And hence, we have proved it also. So, hope you understand. Okay, now look at the next question quickly. If mod of x plus 2 less than or equal to 9, then. So, these are the options. We can able to clearly say which is the right option because the similar pattern of question which we have done it already. Mod of x plus 2 less than or equal to 9. So what is the first step? Immediate step, minus 9 less than or equal to x plus 2 less than or equal to plus 9. Okay? So now subtract 2 on both the sides. So what will you get? Minus 9 minus 2 is minus 11 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 9 minus 2 is 7. Now tell me which is the right option. Look at the options. Easily we can say that. So option B is the right answer. So again I told you from these type of questions you can easily guess by looking at the options. Ye to nahi hoga, C and D cannot be possible. And less than or equal to is there. Therefore open interval is not possible. Option B should be the absolute answer for this question. So hope you understand. Okay. So similar kind of questions I will post you. Just to go through those questions and solve it. If you get the answers, comment it. So one mark will be in your hand. So thank you everyone.